Good morning, everyone. We will start the session today. Around 140 remote centers have joined. The others are trickling in. The main session will start in another 10-15 minutes. So what I'll do for the first 15 minutes is do a floor transfer and interact with all the remote centers who have queries and questions. So all the remote centers who have queries and questions, please raise their hands now. For the first 15 minutes, I'll be doing an interaction session with all the remote centers. So first it is 1281, SVER College of Engineering, Pandharpur.
Sir, yesterday there was one problem that audibility and video clarity was not there.
Okay.
That was the question.
So are you able to see the video and audio clearly now?
Yes, sir.
Wait for a minute.
So apparently it seems there is a small technical change at our end. Please wait for a minute. I'll take the questions from other remote centers. Just wait for a minute. We'll continue the interaction. Okay. We are back to the interaction. So yesterday, many people were having audio video complaints and there was a small issue with IIT Bombay X. We have rectified most of it and the lab assignment is scheduled for tonight at 12 o'clock. Now this is RC1106, Meenakshi Institute of Technology, Yelahanka, Bangalore. Nitya Meenakshi Institute of Technology.
Yeah, hello, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
So yesterday, because of server error, I was not able to do a lab assignment.
Yes.
And after that, when I went home and I searched, that lab assignment option itself is not there in my total after login. So what am I supposed to do?
One second, let me just check. So the lab assignment has been released for all students. So if you actually look at IIT Bombay X now,
yes.
I can see the lab assignment one coming for all the students.
Uh-huh.
So do not worry, you have time till tonight at 12 to do the lab assignment one.
But as of now, like in my login, it is not coming. From yesterday evening till I saw today, it was not coming.
Can you check now?
Lab assignment one option itself is not visible in my lab.
So what I see from my end.
Sure, I'll check it.
Yeah, so what I see from my end is that the students are able to see the lab assignment. So if there are issues regarding that, do let us know. We'll check and make it open, available till 12 o'clock today, 12 at night.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I'll move to 1225, BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore.
Good morning, JK sir.
Yeah,
this
good
is
morning.
Professor Ashok.
Yeah, tell me, Professor Ashok.
Yesterday, we had a lot of discussion on mentor-mentee model in the afternoon sessions.
Okay.
Of course, there was no clarity from the IIT Bombay X, from the AVU.
Okay.
The audio was there was a problem. But there were many associate faculties at our RC and we tried our level best to convince our participants.
Huh.
Still, they have still some confusions. I thought you were the right person to summarize in 2 minutes what it is all about.
Okay. So,
mentor-mentee model.
Yeah. So, this is a valid question. This is BMS College is asking about the mentor-mentee model that will be applied in this particular FDP. Now, let me tell you, so previously when there were synchronous workshops that were happening with remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator helping out in the actual synchronous workshop, we are slowly moving away from the model of the workshop coordinator and remote center coordinator. That will still be there, but for the FDPs, the new model is people who do well in the first offering of the FDP, in the previous offering of the FDP, they will be offered a chance to become associate faculty in the course when it is offered next. So, last year we had the same offering and around 253 participants had emerged as the top performers. Now, we had separately invited them to be part of the associate faculty team, of which around 184 people have kindly agreed to be part of this particular FDP. Now, what is the role of a mentor or a mentee? Now, this is equivalent to, let's say, a senior who has done the same course. Let's say, from the engineering colleges, let's say there is a third year or fourth year student who has completed some courses and is has emerged as good performers, the teachers using them as teaching mentors for the junior students. So what the mentors do, the mentors motivate the mentees who are the participants for the current FDP, clarify their doubts and also interact with them continuously so as to ensure that the goals of the FDP gets fulfilled. Now, Professor Phatak had informed us about the idea of collaborating communities. So we have around 180 mentors, and each mentor might be getting around 40 to 50 mentees under them. So there is, it's like a small community which is continuously interacting with each other, and what will happen is there will be exchange of ideas, there will be exchange of best practices, and there will be a more better rapport between various engineering or teaching faculty across the country. Now this is the vision that Professor Phatak had shared yesterday morning in the interaction session. So I hope people got a better clarity regarding the mentor-mentee model right now. We'll be coming back to BMS College. I believe that Professor Phatak will be joining you in some time. Let me take two more questions for this interaction. Thakur College 1068.
Morning, sir. This is Manish Rana from Thakur College.
Yeah, hi, Manish. Manish, your video seems to be there seems to be a haze in your video. You may have to stop and start the AVU to have a better clarity. Just the video.
Okay.
Just the video.
We'll take care of
but
that.
You can ask the question.
Yeah, question is that will you be teaching us some tools which we can use in a smart classroom in this interaction?
So the question is, will there be some tools that we will deal in smart classroom? So as of now, we have not put that in the agenda because the tools that we are talking about, for many teachers, smart classrooms are slowly coming up across the country. So as and when it gets more popular, we'll be putting those content in the FDP. For the current FDP, it is not there. But what we'll try to do is, we'll put those some videos regarding smart classroom softwares in one of the learning extension resources in the coming weeks. Okay. So, did I answer your query, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let me go to 1063 DY Patil Institute of Technology, Pimpri, Pune.
Good morning. I am Professor Rupa Bindu. I am a faculty of thermal and fluid subjects in mechanical engineering.
Okay.
Now, first I would like to congratulate the team of Bombay IITX. It's a great initiative of NME ICT, which has been executed by Bombay IITX. Thanks for that.
Great.
And the tools like the ICT tools like website and blog, this will be very much helpful for my students for grasping of the subject.
Great to hear that.
Thanks for that. But one thing I want to ask you, sir, that this is regarding the understanding part which we are concentrating, that is use of ICT in grasping of the knowledge by the students. But the question is like this, that as a teacher, we are much concerned about the monitoring, assessment and monitoring of the students. So I just want to ask that, is there any such quick tool in ICT available by which we can immediately come to know about the slow learners, fast learners in the class, and so that we can take action accordingly on the slow learners? You know that the teaching time saves 9.
So, okay.
Is there any monitoring tool available, quick and easy?
Okay, so the question that has been posed by RC1063 is, are there any ICT tools that will help in monitoring and assessment? So the quick answer is that the learning management systems like Moodle, or let's say even IIT Bombay X, is one of the mechanisms through which you can do monitoring and assessment. Now, websites, blogs, etc. are basically content management systems wherein you will provide content to the students and they will be, it is only dissemination of the content. Whereas in learning management, that is the place where the actual learning gets measured, the activities are provided, and you can actually monitor how each student has performed in the course. So, quick answer, learning management systems are the easiest way of doing it. Okay.
Thank you.
One final question from RC1316, Dronacharya College of Engineering.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, I have just one question regarding AppDP 201X.
Okay.
I'm a little early. Will it be possible to include clickers in the classroom as somebody was asking smart tools in the classrooms?
Okay. So the question is whether clickers can be used in the classroom, smart classrooms. So will it be included in the FDP? Currently in this edition, it won't be there because we are almost using the same curriculum that we had used in the last, the last FDP. Almost the same curriculum has been used in the current year. But if more people request these kind of software to be included in the curriculum, we'll definitely look on it. At the moment, what we can do is we can provide it as learning extension resources that you can do a self-exploration and understand.
Sir, one more question, sir.
Yeah.
Regarding AVU connectivity.
Okay.
Most of the time, they are depending on the Bombay server.
Okay.
Will it be possible to have a local server? Machine can be designated as a local server and configure. Is there any provision in the system?
So,
just for your practice purpose.
So basically, the question is, can AVU be installed locally? The answer is yes, technically yes. However, what is required is you need to have a competent team who can configure it properly. The request has to be placed to Amrita e-learning system or IIT Bombay, who will help you out in the local installation.
Sure. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, around 158 remote centers have joined as of now. So let me start the session for today. So it is, the session is about how to optimally use the FDP in your own teaching learning, and how can you obtain the maximum benefit out of this FDP. So let me just quickly go to the courseware of IIT Bombay X and start from there. So yesterday, many people were asking doubts regarding discussion forum, the clarity of discussion forum, it is unable to search, and other queries like that. So what I'm going to do right now is, first I'll talk about how to better use the discussion forum of IIT Bombay X for effective teaching learning through this FDP. So what I am going to do now is share my screen. So what I'll do is I'll just okay. So what you can see over here is I'll go to the discussion forum of IIT Bombay X, the FDP 101X that you are currently seeing. I'll explain to you how to better navigate the discussion forum and some etiquettes regarding how to best use the discussion. Just hold on for a second. We are experiencing some technical difficulties with IIT Bombay X. So I'll come back to the IIT Bombay X in a short while. Sorry for the technical glitch. The IIT Bombay X server seems to be not responding at this moment. We'll just check and get back to you. So quickly, within discussion forum, what is happening is that there are structures, tags through which you can access the discussion forum. Now, this is on the left hand side of the menu button. You can actually see the unread discussions, unanswered discussions, and you can sort it by recent activity and most activity. So when you actually go to the IIT Bombay X, what is required is that you use the features of the discussion forum effectively and then participate in the interaction with your peers. I'll also talk about the pedagogic modifications that were made in the videos, the activities, and the quizzes to ensure that you get effective use of, you make effective use of this course. Now, the first thing that you can see is that there are, each video is now a learning dialogue with reflection spots. So, this is a terminology that we have coined at our end to make where we call the MOOC as a learner-centered MOOC. And what we want teachers to experience while going through this FDP is experience the course as a student. Now, when you experience the course as a student, what will happen is, so what happens is each of you will understand what all are the difficulties faced by the students while using ICT or while trying to do effective teaching learning. Also, we are actually providing some additional methodologies through which you could make your own course more interesting and more effective. Now, one of them is the learning experience interaction. Now, how this happens is, once you complete, let's say, one topic within your course where you have discussed the key concepts, what is required is you make a structured discussion among students of your class and ensure that all the misconceptions or alternate conceptions are elicited out and gets addressed within the classroom itself. And ICT is actually helping you in this process, because more time will be spent in the, when you use ICT effectively, more time will be spent in the classroom for activities like discussions or other active learning pedagogies, and you can actually clarify the doubts of the students who are who have, let's say, now somebody said about slow learners and fast learners. So each of these could be now clubbed together, let's say grouped together, and you can still make an effective discussion within the classrooms. Now, this is what we want to want you to experience first, such that you can then take it forward in your own classroom. Now, each of the pedagogic features that we are trying out in the MOOC, the FDP101X, is actually coming from a face-to-face classroom. Because, so if you take the example of learning dialogues, it is actually equivalent to a teacher pausing their lecture and asking a question to the students. Now, students will note this. So if they are, let's say they are doing note taking or other things, they will actually think about the content that has been discussed till this point and then write the answers to the question or answer back to the teacher within the classroom. Now, in an online environment, we are facilitating it through course journals, where course journals will be individual records of learning, and we are actually asking you to reflect further about the actual learning that has happened in the FDP. Now, about learning by doing activity, what we are saying is that as soon as some content has been discussed, you should immediately provide an activity for the students who will be able to, which will help in reinforcing the concept that were discussed in the classroom. Now, one method through which this could be done using ICT, let's say things like blogs or learning management systems like Moodle, you can provide the content to be discussed outside the classroom. They will watch, let's say, videos, they will read through documents, they will also go through various resources provided by the teacher. Now, inside the classroom, now what the teacher does is, teacher provides specific questions for the students to engage in the content, and they may do lot of activities to ensure that whatever content has to be discussed gets actively understood by the student. Yet another feature that we are trying to do in the IIT Bombay X is also providing you practice of the technology first before giving you assignments about the technology. Now, if you actually look at the week 2 content, we had actually provided only practice activity for you regarding WordPress page. And one good thing that has happened is many of the associate faculty have chipped in and provided guidelines, clarified doubts, and also within the discussion forum, they are answering many of the queries raised by the participants. Now, this is something unique about this FDP, wherein all the associate faculty are actively engaged in ensuring that all the participants get benefited through this FDP 101X. Now, yesterday what has happened was when during the lab assignment session, when the server was down for a moment, some of the associate faculties across various remote centers actually engaged participants in activity within the within their remote centers. And I would congratulate all the associate faculty for showing their earnestness and actively getting involved in the course. And what is happening is these kind of efforts is what I talked earlier in the mentor-mentee model. The rapport between the faculty is getting increased, and we hope to have a larger community evolve out of these various offerings of the FDP. Let me now speak about little about the actual mentor-mentee interaction that we had demonstrated yesterday. Now, we are actually grouping different people based on their domains, their cities, the institutes, etc., such that there is nearness of the mentor with the mentee, either in terms of physical location or in terms of the domain of the participant. However, since there are only 184 mentors and there are around 7,000 participants, we cannot always ensure that there is a one-to-one mapping between either the domain or the cities or the institutes. So what will each mentor have is a group of various faculty, let's say from arts, science, engineering, law, etc. And what it will do is, with teachers interacting with each other during the mentorship sessions, we are trying to break the silos of domains, wherein the electronics faculty will not talk to a civil engineering faculty, or let's say a mechanical faculty is not talking to a electrical faculty, saying that the domains are completely different. Because if you actually see the kind of problems that we are facing, they are truly interdisciplinary. And for teachers to provide effective teaching learning, it is actually important that teachers move beyond domains and engage with other teachers and improve their understanding. What I'll do at this moment, now that I have explained the basic agenda of optimally using the FDP, I will transfer the floor for questions, where I see a lot of hand raises coming from different institutions. Let me now go to center 1250. Yeah, center 1250, Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Kolhapur. Center 1250, I'm unable to hear your audio. I'll come back to you after I take some more questions from other remote centers. Now, this is Maulana Azad Institute of National Institute of Technology, Bhopal. Center 1001.
Hello.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir. Tell me.
Sir, I am Manoj Singh.
Good morning, sir.
Sir, yesterday in your session, your video and audio was 80% is good, but 20% time we can't hearing properly. Okay. And all the questions are based on it. How can we solve?
Okay. So the question is about, so are you able to, quick question, are you able to see me and hear me clearly now?
Yes.
Okay, so let me answer this query. So this query is that sometimes my video and audio from IIT Bombay is not coming clear at several remote centers. So to all remote centers, the clarity of audio and video at your end will depend upon the local server at your institution and the bandwidth that you have. Okay, so the actually the clarity would depend upon the local bandwidth. So let's say if you do not have the 2 Mbps connection that is prescribed for AVU interactions, sometimes the AVU login may not be clear, AVU interactions may not be clear. So what you have to ensure is that the infrastructure at your end, the server and the internet bandwidth gets checked consistently and ensure that there are no drops in bandwidth.
But your all question based on it, how can we solve? My question is that.
Basically, you will have to improve the local infrastructure and ensure that there is consistent bandwidth at your end. So your service provider, internet service provider, you will have to check with them and ensure that they are consistently providing you the required 2 Mbps bandwidth at your end.
Sir, this is Arvind Singh Tomar from Molana Yat, remote center.
Yeah, tell
me,
sir.
Would it be possible to have a some textual information over there so that we can read it?
So are you asking about AVU guidelines or session slides?
I have a simple question that if we cannot hear and not see it, then can we have the textual messages over the screen so that we can read it?
Okay, so textual messages on the screen, it is, see, the issue is we are presenting the video or whatever, the let's say slides from our end, and it will actually depend on the bandwidth at your end, whether you are able to see it clearly. Now, if the video itself is not coming out clear, then there is less chance that you can see the slides or other uploaded documents clearly at your end. I'll ask my studio team head, Sajjan Dikshit, to answer your query now.
Hello. So I think you are talking about the scripted talk. We don't have any scripted talk. It is live talk. So you won't get any textual appearance on the AVU. We can't feed it. It is naturally elaborated by Jay Krishnan. We don't have scripted talk. So you can't get that kind of text. But you have to make sure that your bandwidth is not fluctuating. If it fluctuates, then you will get this kind of issues. Is there any problem from IIT Bombay side, just try to understand, all will get the same problem.
The problem is listed in the user chat that they are not getting the voice and the videos clearly.
Yeah, I understand. Some of the out of 167, 5 to 10 remote centers, they have this issue because their bandwidth is fluctuating and they don't have adequate audio system. Therefore, audio and video, they are using the issues in
that. Activities are based on them. The graded activities are based on it. So if we cannot hear and see the audios and videos,
so
it is possible for us to answer the graded activities.
So another, the transmission we are hosting on the YouTube live channel, that is also recorded there. So if you are unable to attend that session or you have a difficulty in any session on a particular part, then you can just get that streaming videos on our channel.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So let me now go to KK Wag Institute 1088.
Good morning, everybody. My question will be somewhat out of context. In yesterday's session, Professor Pathak mentioned that we should be very careful about plagiarism. Yeah, my query is regarding, if I regenerate something looking at a reading of or a diagram and then produce in the video, will it come under a violation of the Copyright Act? Second thing is, if I use any freeware which has been downloaded from an internet and use it to develop a particular figure or a structure and regenerate it in the video, will it be a violation of the Copyright Act?
Okay, so the question is regarding plagiarism, wherein there is something that has been regenerated at based on, let's say, some videos or some material or some software and used in our own educational resources. Now, the quick answer to it is, you'll have to check what is the IPR of the original material and what is the copyright saying about it. If it is a Creative Commons resource, then you will be, there is no issue. And Creative Commons, there are different licenses through which it is being distributed. So suppose there is a CC BY or Creative Commons, just the Creative Commons attribution, then you are free to use it in any way you want. There is another license called Creative Commons by Share Alike, wherein you will have to use the same license of the original material. So basically, you will have to look at the source material and its copyright to understand the plagiarism or the IPR implications.
Thank you, sir. If the company or the copyright holder provides me with a letter of no objection, can it be used to develop and reproduce the video?
Yes. So, if you Professor Phatak had yesterday told about the case where Professor Uday Gaitonde in one of the earlier courses had used the same thing. He contacted the original person who had developed the steam tables and got his permission to reuse it. Now, the permission will be provided by the person who created it, and they will be clearly telling you whether it could be used for commercial or non-commercial purposes.
Yes, sir. I am satisfied. Thank you, sir.
What I'll do right now is, I believe Professor Phatak is at BMS College of Engineering. I'll just go to BMS College now. Yeah, Dr. Ashok, is Professor Phatak in at your institute?
No, not yet. I haven't received any call.
Okay. So, we are expecting. So, one thing, so I'll come back to you. So, as soon as you, Professor Phatak arrives, do let us know. Let me tell about one thing that we are doing in this FDP. So, you would see a lot of associate faculty coming to various remote centers and joining for the interaction. Similarly, our own course instructors are present across various going to various institutes and participating in the interaction from these remote institutes. Now, this is something that we are trying for this particular FDP, wherein we can we will be able to involve more of the teaching learning, more of the faculty from each institute, and encourage and motivate them to do well in the FDP. So, you will have a lot of us coming, let's say, during the synchronous interaction, in between the course or after the course, to several of your institutes and interacting with you. Let me now take a question from 1101.
Yesterday, Dr. Phatak had said that we need not be very over enthusiastic about going for the flipped classroom. There should be some mountain range which we should decide while thinking about our course. Can you suggest what should be that percentage in terms of going for a flip classroom kind of an delivery with conventional delivery when I mix both of them?
Okay. So the question from the remote center is, so let me answer this question. The question is, what all things need to be taken care while actually going for a flipped classroom mode of delivery. Now, one main thing that you have to look at is, are the learning objectives that you have for your students being satisfied by, let's say, use of ICT outside the classroom or engaging in discussion within the classroom? Second thing, the context in which you are actually operating. So, let's say if you have a large percentage of students who do not have access to ICT resources, then providing videos or other materials outside the classroom is going to be difficult. Now, the third thing is about the regular practice that both you and your students are comfortable with. Now, let's say when you are trying out any new ICT tool or let's say any new pedagogy, what you have to keep in mind is how comfortable you are with the change in pedagogy. And it may so happen that you may have done very well in finding out resources, designing activities, just because the students were not familiar to this mode of teaching learning, there will be resistance from the student side. Now, this is very important when you are using any ICT tool. You will have to look at how comfortable both you and your students are with the technology. Let me now go to 1278, SDM Institute of Technology, Ujire.
I have a query on WebPress creation.
Okay.
Will it be considered for resource creation assignment?
The question is WordPress creation, will it be considered for resource creation assignment? The answer is yes, but we will be doing this in the fifth week of the course. The specific resource creation assignment in WordPress will come in the fifth week of this course. Currently, it is for practice. Now, you have to be familiar with the technology first, then only you can do the assignment. So, one full week is given for you to practice the technology.
I have one more query.
Yeah.
Few of my friends are unable to attend this program.
Okay.
So, is there any, they have wished to continue the assignments.
Are they registered in this program?
Yes, they are registered, but they are not a part of face-to-face interaction.
Okay, so the question is, some participants are not part of the face-to-face interaction, but they would want to be continuing in the FDP and do the later assignments. What is the policy for that? Now, see, the synchronous interactions are important because of two reasons. One is because participants can interact with instructors at IIT Bombay, and second, you will be interacting among yourselves. Let's say a remote center has an associate faculty. This is one place where physical interactions can happen during the course. Now, at the start of the course itself, we have said that the synchronous interactions are mandatory. However, the exact policy, as in if there are some unavoidable circumstances, will take decision based on individual case. So the general answer is no, they have to be part of the synchronous interaction. If there are unavoidable circumstances, they should let us know so that we can take some decision on it.
My friend has one more query.
Yeah.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
So I also had a question regarding WordPress. That is, I have downloaded it in my cell phone as an app. Whether creating a website in a cell phone, will it be same as creating it on laptop? Does it make any difference for the course? I have even customized it on my smartphone also.
Okay. So this is an interesting scenario wherein, okay, let me repeat the question to all other participants for the benefit of all other participants. One participant has downloaded the WordPress mobile app in the phone and is trying to do the WordPress page creation using it. Will it affect the main FDP scores or resource creation assignments? The answer is no. You are free to use any ICT device that you want, as long as you are able to satisfy the questions, the conditions in the question. Now, WordPress mobile app is fastly gaining popularity, so many of the teaching learning apps that you applications that you are seeing within this course, nowadays the mobile applications for each of this is coming. So Moodle also has a mobile app, WordPress also has a mobile app, so these things are coming. Even screen recording in mobile is also possible. So we will not distinguish between let's say a mobile submission or a submission from let's say a desktop. Now, what is important while using it in your own teaching learning classroom is to see whether your students are able to see whatever information or whatever is your objective, is it getting satisfied with the use of WordPress created using a mobile app.
So thank you very much for that answer, sir.
Yeah.
So one more doubt is that in the fifth week when we are asked to do that activity on the WordPress, can I continue with the mobile site itself?
Sure, sure.
If not for the teaching activity, yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Now I am going to NMIMS Shirpur. RC1103.
Yes, this is RC1103. I'm Dr. Payal Dande, Associate Faculty for NMMS Shirpur Campus, sir.
Yeah, tell me, Payal.
The question is, yesterday some of the faculty members has missed the session due to genuine official workload which was there with them. And there are so many faculties who are registered for this particular FDP. It was next to impossible to even adjust those workloads. So how to take care of this loss?
Okay, the question is regarding absence in synchronous interactions due to workload. We understand that yes, there are issues regarding workload. That's why at the start of the workshop itself, we get the permission letters from each faculty saying that they'll be allowed to attend AVU interactions. Now, why this discrepancy happened? Again, each of the case has to be handled case by case. There are no standard policies. The standard policies, faculty must attend the synchronous interaction.
Sir, I am Dr. Mohan Awasthi.
Yeah.
I have a question that whatever the ICT that we are following is for classroom teaching.
Okay.
Now, the major problem that we are facing at this moment, in the especially in the technology, is that the how to effectively conduct the labs. Because what happens that in engineering education, what we are facing is that the students are not able to convert their ideas into the projects.
Okay.
So if they want to have their ideas converted into the project, we have to give them the lab assignments or how effectively the lab has conducted. So do you have any plans of in this FDP for getting how effectively the labs are conducted by using this ICT methods?
Okay.
Like on source softwares or any other things.
Okay.
This is what my question is. Thank you.
Yeah, so the question is there some content in this FDP regarding effective teaching learning within labs? Now, in the pedagogy aspect of this course, which comes in FDP 201X, we'll be dealing with several pedagogic techniques that can be used both inside the classroom and even in the lab. Now, how effectively you can use it depends on each individual teacher and the students of the teacher. So the pedagogic aspect of teaching learning in lab will be covered in the FDP 201X. Let me now move over to 1005 Anna University, Chennai.
My question is on open source softwares like Scilab, OpenFOAM and LaTeX.
Okay.
Will there be a sensitization in the FDP that follows now?
So the question is, will there be sensitization regarding open source softwares? Yes, across multiple FDPs, we'll be providing you various open source softwares. Currently, Scilab is not part of the larger picture, but what we'll do is we'll provide learning extension resources for Scilab or other similar open source softwares that can be used by faculty.
I have one more question.
Yeah.
First of all, thank you for conducting this workshop.
Okay.
And we are very much benefited with that.
Huh.
My question is, there are some interesting things in the video. The best part we like this, it's a 3 to 10 minutes video where students will not get distracted. That's a short time. And another point is, some of the parts of video are very interesting. So if I would like to share that video to my fellow faculty, so how can I do that without logging in into IIT Bombay?
Okay, the question is,
like for example, yeah, the visual resources.
Yeah, so the question is, how can videos of this FDP be shared with other faculty? Now, all the resources that we have created as part of this FDP is in Creative Commons. If you actually look at the video videos, there is a link, YouTube link of these videos that are available on top of it. So what you have to do is just share the YouTube link of these videos with your friends. But know that if they want to use it, just ensure that they provide attribution to IIT Bombay team, saying that the ideas were, because it is in Creative Commons by share alike. So if they want to propagate it further and use some parts of the video, they will also have to ensure that the videos that they create are also in Creative Commons.
Thank you.
Yeah. So
one more query. Can you please give the documentation on the Creative Commons license in the course of this website so that their use would be known to us?
Yes. So
larger clarity.
There will be, we will be providing you some sensitization and some resources regarding various Creative Commons application. We will be dealing this in week 4 and week 5, where we'll be talking of video creation and finally putting all together for a final output. So we will be dealing with Creative Commons and intellectual property related modules while in week 4 as well as in week 5.
Thank you for your answers.
Yeah. So let me now go to CDAC Noida.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Thanks a lot for a nice, wonderful workshop. Actually, there are two questions and two requests.
Okay.
The first question is that those videos that were part of this course, can we download and keep a copy for us?
So the answer is yes, you can, because they are put under Creative Commons.
Then the other request, the first request is that the lecture resource from Dr. Sahasrabuddha were very nice. That was posted yesterday.
Okay.
And apparently it seems that it is a series of lectures.
Yes.
And I tried to find out in all in the IIT Bombay channel, but not successful. So is there a possibility that we do get links of those?
We have Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddha doing the next session immediately at 11:30, so that you can actually ask him for more videos, links related to the videos, etc.
No, actually, to be frank with, I can ask, but asking question here is a sort of a winning a lottery.
The series of videos, they were just two videos that were part of the visual communication skills. We have Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddha doing an entire session from 11:30 to 1, just immediately after this session. So you can actually see, get the lottery of Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddha talking in this FDP session.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Then there is one more question. The second question is that if we go through the discussion forums, there are a lot of apprehensions about ICT being invading teacher space or what. So can there be sort of a video covering or answering these questions?
Okay. The question is about some of the common questions that are being posted in discussion forum. We'll definitely create a final doubt clarification video wherein we'll consolidate all the doubts raised by several participants and try to make it into either a video. But I think making a video would be too lengthy because there are a lot of queries. What we'll try to do is we'll try to provide documents wherein we explain the answer. So we will be sharing several PDFs which will answer these questions that has been raised through the surveys and the discussion forums.
And one final question from my side. Yesterday there, when we were discussing about, it was raised that there is a problem in creating discussion forums of about 60-70 people. Right, why can't we use Moodle for that?
The question is, why can't we use Moodle for discussion forums? The answer is that then there will be two different platforms through which participants have to switch between it. The previous FDP was done using both IIT Bombay X and Moodle, and participants found it really inconvenient to switch between platforms. That's why we have decided a uniform decision that all the activities will happen in IIT Bombay X.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So,
hello.
Let me now go to Center 1345, Supreme College of Engineering, Supreme Knowledge Foundation, 1345.
Hello.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Yeah.
My first question is, in ABU interaction between a mentor and a mentee, suppose a mentee is interacting with a mentor and at the same time I want to show him some equations which I am writing on a paper. So is there any provision for third window or multiple windows coming in, where in one window I can show some doubts while solving some equations and any written text?
Okay. So, question number one. So, I'll answer this query wherein is there provision for the mentees to show their written text through AView in a separate window? The answer is no. Only the mentor can have multiple interactions permitted because he or she has the teacher privilege. The mentees can, what you can do is show it through the video itself where the interaction is happening.
Okay. My second question is, in the discussion forum, there are some questions which I am asking, some queries.
Okay.
But after I ask that query and post it, then second day when I open the discussion forum, I see that all the other participants' query responses are coming in and my queries are getting lost.
Okay.
So how do I segregate my queries and responses from all other responses from other participants and all?
Okay.
Because I have to search and all. It is,
yes.
If a separate window is there by which I can see my own queries and the response,
so
getting lost in the crowd.
So the answer, so the question is, how can one participant see his own posts in discussion forums? Because there are around 7,000 people interacting at the same time, it gets lost in the discussion forum. The answer is, you can actually click on posts I am following. So there is a star button in each post. If you actually create a post, you will automatically follow the post that you are creating. And what you can do is, from the search button in the discussion forum menu, which is on the left hand top, so there will be three arrows, horizontal arrows on the left hand side. You can click on it and you can select posts I am following. And you can see the queries that you have posted or other discussion posts that you are following. Now let me go to the next remote center, Audi Shankara College, 1345.
So we have a query related to this WordPress.com.
Okay.
After creating the blog and website, one of our faculty members has posted the link in the discussion forum.
Okay.
But whenever we are trying to open the link, it's directing towards the user ID and password.
Okay, so...
And the name which the IIT Bombay account is actually open.
Yeah, so what...
How we can go through that link and get the data on that?
Okay, so the question is, what happens is the link that has been shared in WordPress is, after clicking it, it is asking for user ID and password. So one thing that you have to do is... you have to select visit site, and so in the dashboard, select the visit site option and select the public page that is visible in WordPress, and that link has to be shared with other participants. And what you can ask other participants who are posting these user ID, the links that is asking for user ID, kindly respond to them saying that please provide the public link of the page.
One more question, sir.
Yeah.
From the same college. In the assimilation quiz of week 2, question number 3 and 4 were quite critical and we could not arrive to a conclusion. We had a great follow-up in the discussion hour, but still we were in physical mode.
Okay. I will look into this question because I also saw a lot of queries regarding the assimilation quiz 2. Let me just check the question and I'll try to see, find some common policy for questions that are ambiguous or are having some problem in understanding.
Sir, I have some queries regarding grading activities, sir.
Okay.
Actually, you said that for the first 2 week grading activities, after that you will forward these people to for the third week. When we can get that conclusion, sir?
Can you repeat the question once again?
Actually, based on the graded activities, we'll forward to the next sessions. We got the information that the based on the grading activities and the performance in the grading activities, we'll move to the next session. So is it possible to move the next session for the third week?
No. So see, the thing is, so the question is moving to the next session. So all the week contents are available for you to access freely. So the week 3 content has been released and you can access the content without completing the week 2 graded activities. But every graded activity has a due date before which you have to complete. If you don't complete the graded activity, it will affect your grades. So it's like, you can still be in the class without attending one or two exams or short tests in your own classrooms. But your overall grade will be affected because of your absence in those tests or quizzes.
Total 5 weeks we'll consider, sir.
Yes. So the grading policy has been elaborated in the video, as well as there is a document for grading policy. Kindly go through the document once again.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. So 1225 once again. Center 1225 is Professor Phatak in at your institute? Apparently Professor Phatak has not yet come.
No, not yet come.
Okay. I'll just move to the other remote centers now. RBS College of Engineering. Let me go to 1136, PSG College of Technology.
Hi, I'm Deepak. I've just got some basic question. Usually for this normal classroom teaching, we'll be focusing on these weak students based on one-on-one interaction.
Okay.
So for this, but when we use this ICT, how can we give more focus on this below average students?
Okay. Now the question is about below average students or weak students. First of all, this idea of below average or weak students have to be removed from our mindset, because every student is capable of doing wonderful things. Only thing is, they are not being provided with the correct facilities, or they do not have access to these facilities while doing their teaching learning. Now, you could use lot of the student-centered pedagogy to ensure that these students come up, they improve their performance of learning and participate. So, it is not just dependent upon ICT. It is actually dependent upon the way a teacher facilitates classroom interactions. Okay, now I'll move to center 1255, Mount Zion College.
Sir, good morning, sir. Actually, my question is mentor-mentee interaction, regarding mentor-mentee interaction.
Okay.
Sir, is it possible to have interaction with the multiple mentor with the different location with the single mentee group?
So the answer in this, yeah, I got your question. The question is whether a mentee group can have interaction with multiple mentors. Now, for this FDP, yeah, we have only one mentor to a group of mentees. Oh. So this many to many interaction will not be possible.
Thank you. One more question.
Sir, is it possible to have a mobile app for mentee-mentor interaction?
Can you repeat the question? Okay, the question is it possible to have a mobile app? So you have lot of, so if you are comfortable with sharing your mobile number and other things, you could interact with your mentor using WhatsApp or other applications that are available in mobile. Now it is up to the convenience of the mentor and mentee to decide what is the mechanism through which they are going to interact. What we will provide from our side is, apart from this, there will be one session through AVU through which they could interact in FDP 101X. There will be slots open in FDP 101X in the coming days, where at least one interaction is possible between one mentor and a group of mentees. Okay, so let me now go to Tejpur University, Center 1153. Sir, you are not audible.
No.
Yeah.
Hello, Jayakrishnan, can you hear me?
Yes, now I can.
Okay, so I have a direct question regarding the discussion forum that we are using in this for this particular FDP.
Okay.
So in the discussion forum, the problem is there are too many threads or discussion that is being posted by the more than 7,000 participants.
Yes.
So what happens, most of the times we may miss some important discussions or the category wise.
Okay.
So will it be possible, or what would be the way for the best use of those discussions?
Okay.
That we know as a categorically, rather than having all the discussions in one place and difficult to find it out.
Okay, so I have answered this question right at the start, and I've also answered it again. So it's regarding discussion forum. So there is a menu button through which you can actually do lot of things, like you can sort the discussions, you can look at most active discussions, you can look at your own discussion threads, and participate effectively in the discussion forum. Now in the morning there was a small technical glitch through which due to which I was not able to share my IIT Bombay X discussion forum with you. What I'll do is in the afternoon between 2 and 2:30 I will create a separate session just for the discussion forum, wherein I'll provide you with slides through which you will understand how to sort the discussion forums and participate effectively.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sorry, can I just add into it something?
Yeah, please tell me.
Yeah, Krishna. Can I? Okay. No, my question is not that highly discussed threads. I just want to know that category that infrastructure difficulty wise, say discussion on that. Discussion on, say, a category which says that it is problem of finding resources. Say third is blending between the using ICT and the physical face-to-face interaction. So would it be possible to make those kind of categories rather than just looking into the highly discussed topic and all those?
Okay, so the question is, can there be categorization based on things that are more interesting to the learner, if I'm not mistaken? So one quick way of doing it is you can click on that star button where it says follow, and all the posts that you follow, the interesting posts that you want to follow, will come under the menu bar posts I am following in your discussion forum. So this is one easy way of tagging specific discussion forums that you want to explore or keep tabs on. I'll take the final two queries. One is RVR and JC College 1363. Ma'am, your audio is not audible. Unable to hear your audio, ma'am. Can you check your mic? No audio. I'll come back to RVR and JC. I'll take one college, one more remote center, 1135 Periyar, 1136, 1135 Periyar Maniammai University, Tanjavur. Yeah, tell me, sir. Sir, you are, I'm having an echo in your audio. I can hear you, but there is an echo, so speak slowly. Sir, there is a lot of echo in your voice. I'm not able to hear you. Can you just do a one final check of your audio? I'm unable to hear you, sir. I'll come back to you in the afternoon. I'll go to 1034 now, ME Societies, IMCC Pune. Ma'am, can you check your audio?
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
All of us have a doubt, and the doubt relates to using the reflection spot and the quiz activities. Basically, in a particular course of engineering, we have 5 courses per semester if we are following semester pattern. Mm. And if every faculty decides to make use of the quiz activity using LMS for reinforcement of the learning, the problem that we encounter, because I have tried this out earlier, is students do not actively participate. What is happening in the case if we are doing this FDP is, we as faculty members are going to get acknowledgement in the terms of certificate. But students look at it, what is going to be their benefit or outcome.
Okay.
So from a strength of 60 plus, I have hardly 10% students who actually participate actively in the quiz activity after teaching a particular topic.
So this is one query that we have, how to actually effectively use it to the students.
Okay.
And the second query is with respect to the course journal and the WordPress website that is created. Do we have to upload these documents anywhere? If you are querying from everybody.
Okay. So, thank you for the questions. The first question is regarding activeness of students. So it so happened, many teachers will be facing the same issue that only few percentage of their students are truly active in the class and does all the activity. So there are no shortcuts for this. You will have to coax the students to do the work, provide more student-centered activities that they like. Let's say, so some of the previous FDPs, what we saw was use of activities like think, pair, share or peer instruction in a classroom had motivated students to take part in the classroom discussion. Now, these active learning pedagogy through which you can engage more students will be discussed in FDP 201X. In the current FDP regarding course journal and WordPress, there are no submissions yet of course journal in a, let's say, a file upload assignment for course journal and WordPress. It is only for you to see whether you can practice it right and share with your colleagues and get their inputs in the discussion forum. The exact activity of WordPress upload and course journal upload will come in weeks 4 and 5. I'll take BMS College. Can you tell me whether Professor Fatak is available at your... Okay, so Professor Fatak has informed us that he will join at 11:30. So currently time is 11 o'clock. You will have a session by Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe at 11:30 on visual presentation skills. And Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe will be taking this session from a remote center. So that so this is something, another unique experiment that we are trying out in this FDP where course instructors participate from several remote centers. So I've seen a lot of hand raises. I'll come back to you in the afternoon, wherein we'll discuss a little more about effective use of this FDP. Due to some technical difficulties, you're not able to carry it forward further. But some time will be definitely spent on how to make the best use of this FDP. And then I'll take the queries from other participants. So I hope, so you can now go for a break. We will reassemble at 11:30, where Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe will be taking a session on visual communication skills. Thank you.